Well, let's do a quick recap of where we are in our discussion. We've been talking about AF clients, these users who are running AF clients over here, having a nice tool for going out and finding things they're interested in. And those things are going to be stored in AF. The AF server is the mechanism that, I guess, keeps track of all that routing so that, for example, if the user wants to see a Pi tag, you know, here's a Pi tag, or here's the Pi server. If he wants to see a particular tag on that Pi server, he can use the hierarchical structure that's defined in AF, you know, using this hierarchy to find exactly where within this database you would find that Pi tag. And essentially, that Pi tag is then referenced from here. It's a reference to the data over here. I guess you could even call it a data reference. So that's actually our topic right now. How do we create this data reference that points this attribute over to this Pi tag? And while we're at it, not just Pi tags, but remember, you've got data that might be sitting in a relational database. Now we do have access to that by means of a link that's established between an AF table. We'll talk a lot more about that later on. But again, using this hierarchy that you've built in AF using this tree structure, you can find a specific table that you're interested in. And if that table is linked to this table over here and it's updated on a regular basis, then how could you create that type of a data reference that would go ahead and refer to that particular entry in the SQL table? Now, additionally, you may have a calculation that is on one of these elements here, an attribute of an element in AF. And that calculation is actually something that's done within AF. So it's something that's a data reference to something that's actually stored as part of AF. So in that case, that would be a data reference there. That's another one of the types of data references we support. And you know what? The number of data references that we support is literally endless because it's extensible. If you are a member of vCampus, our virtual campus for learning about programming and working with Pi, you'll have access to examples of creating other data references. So in addition to data references that get data from, you know, say a Pi tag or a Pi tag, you know, that kind of a data reference to this Pi tag is something that's fairly standard that ships with the system. And in addition to a data reference that goes to a linked table, or a data reference that goes to a formula, in addition to those, there can be data references that go out to, well, let's just call it System X. Whose data reference is that? Well, it's yours. You developed it using our vCampus tools, using our development tools. So it is an extensible structure in which, you know, any type of data reference that you can define programmatically, you can get access to. Let's go take a look at the default set of data references that ship with AF. Now you'll notice that when you create an attribute here, one of the options for setting that attribute, or one of the things that you can configure for that attribute, is the data reference. And here are the four defaults. There's the Pi point, there's the table lookup, that could be a linked table to a SQL table or any other relational database, and then there's the formula. Now I've kind of given short shrift to Pi point array. We do support Pi point array and it is available programmatically, but right now none of our clients take advantage of this. So although you can make a data reference to an array of Pi tags and you can actually look at that array inside the Pi System Explorer, none of our client applications exploit that. So unless you're a developer, there's not a lot you're going to be doing with that Pi point array. But those are the default data references that ship with the system. Now, over the next few videos, we're going to be looking at the different types of data references. We're going to save the table data reference for a later chapter. But one thing they all have in common, and also this would be in common with any user-developed data references you create, is if you look at the palette option, there is a data references option there so that you can actually drag and drop new attributes onto an element. So for example, this mixing tank, if I know for a fact that there is a temperature in that mixing tank, I can just click on the Pi point data reference, drag this over, drop it right there, and then start configuring this. This is going to be temperature. And then I would go ahead and specify the pi point by going in here to settings, and we're going to look at more detail on that. But that's an interesting option that's available for all of these data references, plus any data references that you create and register. Well, let's go ahead and create a new attribute that's got a data reference to a pi point. And in this case, let's just do it right here at the same level. Remember, I could make this a child attribute if I select one of these options right here. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to put it on the main level. I can do this two ways, either three ways, really. I can do here, new attribute. I can go down here where there's no area and no attributes already, choose new attribute. Or, as we saw earlier, probably the least or the most overlooked way of doing it is I can just drag this over here by choosing that palette, drag that over here, and just drop it. And that'll create a new attribute for me. It's going to be already defined as a pi point array. Okay, I'll do it the most common way. I'll just do a right click here on the white space, choose new attribute. I want to make sure that this is going to be a pi point attribute. And we'll call this something like outside air. And since there's probably more than one at your site, we'll call that outside air 1. Now notice, since we called that a data reference but we didn't configure it, we're getting a little error message here. Can't find it. So I'm going to go into settings, and this is where I'm going to define what the reference is to, what pi point the reference is to. Now this is one of the few areas in which I guess you're going to be working with both the Pi SDK calls and the AF SDK at the same time. See, this is the point at which the AF database is being informed about something that resides on Pi. So I was telling you that the AF and Pi server can be considered as completely different systems. Or I shouldn't say Pi server, but AF and the Pi data archive server can be considered different systems entirely. And this is where they kind of come together. So you'll notice that when I go out and search, this is now invoking the Pi SDK to go out and search for those things that I might need, those Pi tags. I'll type BA with a colon and an asterisk. I'm looking for this temperature tag. There we go. It's a temperature. It's actually the reactor temperature. Let's pretend it's the outside air temperature here. Now we're going to ignore the attributes for just a second. We're going to come back to that in a second. For the units of measure, we'll go ahead and specify whatever units seem appropriate for, in this case, we probably measure that in degrees Fahrenheit for the humans, if you're in the US, I suppose. And that's all we're going to do at this point. The other options here we're going to cover in more detail later on. We can have context set up so that we can retrieve values that are aggregate values like averages, etc. And we'll look at that later on. Now this option right here, read only, what this does is it controls whether you can write to the tag or attempt to write to the tag from within AF. Now this doesn't really control the whether you succeed or not, just whether you can try to write. See, the normal Pi security is still going to be in place, but this just allows you to set this up so that it's not even going to attempt to or allow you to attempt to write values back to this Pi tag from this client. Now again, if you were to clear this, this doesn't mean you can write, it just means that we will attempt, and then based on your credentials that you're logging into Pi with, that may or may not allow you to write. I'll go ahead and say OK. And what we're going to see now is we're seeing the outside air temperature.